A few years ago when I was still in school, I bought an iPad. I thought, great, I can use it to take notes for school, I can watch Netflix in the evening, and I can even edit my TikTok videos on CapCut. But as I used it more and more, I started to realize that when I needed to get real work done, I would put away my tablet and grab my MacBook. So eventually it would end up in a drawer collecting dust, and I never really got to use it for the purpose that I initially bought it for. But now, that's all about to change. iPadOS 26 is coming this fall, and it aims to do exactly what everyone has been asking them for years: turn the tablet into a real computer. So in today's video, I'm gonna show you how I've been using my iPad over the last 30 days and why the new iPadOS has reignited my love for this tablet. When the iPad was first introduced, we saw it as an iPhone with a bigger screen. Then came some various forms of multitasking, which grouped Windows together. But a lot of users over the last couple of years has asked Apple for a very simple thing. We want true multitasking. So in this new update, that's exactly what Apple did. If you go into your display settings, you can unlock this new feature called windowed mode, and this is where it starts to get interesting. First, you have the ability to take apps and turn them into true windows. And as you can see, I have Chrome open, and if I grab the handle in the bottom right, I can resize it into any sized window that I want. And then I can pop open Spotify to check out what's trending or even play my favorite podcast. And if that's not enough, I can open the calculator app to do some quick calculations while still having all my windows present and in front of me. Second up, we have true cursor support. Gone is that circle cursor that we used to see on the previous iPads, and now we actually have a pointer cursor. Now, this is similar to what you'd find on a normal computer, and you might be asking, is that really that big of a change? But if you're using apps like Figma where precision is necessary, I think it actually makes a big difference. Now, real quick, I did want to mention a couple of other features that are going to be on the new iPadOS. There's a redesigned files app that's similar to what you find on a MacBook, and it just allows you to easily find your files and move stuff around. Preview now also comes to iPadOS, which makes it easier for you to mark up PDFs. Pro apps like Photoshop and Final Cut are no longer watered down and really make use of the power of the Apple Silicon. Now, it's one thing to have good software, but you really need to pair it with good hardware. And I think alone, the iPad does a really good job of this. It's slim enough. Visually, it looks pretty nice, and it doesn't weigh that much either. But one thing that can be difficult is when you're typing on it. And so I've paired my iPad with the Rebound Magnetic Keyboard Case by ESR. And I'll be honest, combining these two together has really leveled up my experience. The keys are soft and comfortable to type on, and the backlighting makes it easier to work on even in dim environments. The trackpad is smooth and responsive. I can use macOS type gestures on the iPad, so it kind of feels like I'm still using my MacBook. Plus, the case supports multi-viewing angles. So whether I'm typing a document, watching a video, or sketching, I can adjust it to the perfect position. But I think the biggest benefit, considering everything else, is the price. Apple sells a similar keyboard. I think it's called the Apple Magic Keyboard, and it costs over $400. This Rebound case costs $140, plus an additional 25% if you use our coupon. But I mean, even then, it's half the cost of the Apple one, and it still has the same level of functionality. Now that we've talked about the core iPad experience, let's talk about the two places where I use it most: in the office or on the go. But of course, an iPad and keyboard can only take you so far. So when I'm in the office, I usually plug it into an external monitor like back here, just so I have that extra screen to get work done. And the monitor that I'm using is the Odyssey G7 by Samsung. I honestly chose this monitor because for me, it was more than just the specs. The colors are beautiful, it has built-in smart features so I can game and stream without a computer, and it makes my desk feel complete. Pairing it with my iPad gives me that extra screen real estate so I can multitask without squinting at a smaller display. It's a 32-inch 4K IPS panel, which means the colors look sharp and the pictures feel vibrant. It features a 144Hz refresh rate and G-Sync, which makes it ideal for gaming. I like the fact that this monitor is flexible. It's powerful enough to use for games, but still simple enough for me to get my everyday work done. On the back, you'll find a generous amount of connectivity. You've got two USB-A ports, as well as a USB-B port, which is used as a hub. For display, you have two HDMI ports, as well as a display port. And something that you don't often see on monitors is the inclusion of a gigabit Ethernet port. There are a few extras that really makes this monitor worthwhile, such as the included remote that allows you to access smart TV apps. The screen can rotate horizontally, vertically, and even sideways for the perfect viewing angle. And it has built-in speakers. Now, they're not at the level of Harman Kardon or Bose speakers, but I'd say that they're pretty good for casual use. Along with my monitor, I'm also using this, the MX Anywhere 3S mouse. And I know a lot of people might say that this is complete overkill, especially since the ESR has a trackpad. The only issue is that the normal MX series focuses more on ergonomics. So when it comes to a portable setup, it can feel a little bit bulky. The Anywhere 3S is basically the little brother to the Master 3S, but it still has the same level of functionality. It has 6 different buttons on it, so you can easily customize it to the iPad OS shortcuts, or even if you want to do some multitasking. Plus, you can also program it on up to 3 different devices. So if I want to switch between my iPad or my MacBook, I don't have to worry about pairing it and unpairing it. I just click one simple button and it connects all my devices. Now, when it comes to sound, I usually prefer to go with an over-ear headphone setup, more so just because I can really focus in on what I'm working on and it leaves little room for distractions. And in my case, I've gone with the Sony XM5s. I've actually had these for a little while now. I used them when I was traveling, I've used them at the gym or even at a coffee shop, and they still perform just like they did when I first bought them. For me, noise canceling is probably the most important feature that I'm looking for when I'm shopping around for headphones, and with these, Sony packs 8 microphones along with a dedicated processor, so it does a pretty good job of removing the chatter and cutting out the low-end background noise. Comfort is also something that's important, especially if I'm going to be wearing these for long periods of time. The XM5s weigh around 250 grams. The ear cups use this soft foam material, and the headband doesn't clamp too hard when you're wearing them. That balance alone makes it easy for you to wear them hours at a time without your ears hurting. Battery life is strong as well. I get about 30 hours of charging on a full charge, especially when I have noise canceling on, and a 3-minute charge can give me 3 hours of battery life, which is perfect if I'm moving around at home or I'm at a coffee shop or I'm just too lazy to charge them all the time. And when I need to hop on a call, the microphone system is surprisingly good. Sony uses beamforming mics along with AI-based noise reduction, so my voice cuts clearly even with background sounds around me. On top of that, the sound quality is exactly what you'd want. It's detailed, balanced, and tuned for both music and focus. Okay, so I've got an iPad and I've got a monitor, but how do I connect them together? Especially when my iPad only has a single USB-C port. Now, that wouldn't be a huge deal if I just wanted to plug in a monitor. I could use a simple DisplayPort cable, but the issue is that I edit on my iPad and sometimes I need to plug in an SD card, or I just have to keep it charging while also having all these things connected. So what do? The simplest and most affordable solution that I found is a USB-C hub, like this Anker 565. This 11-in-1 hub has 3 USB-A ports, a USB-C port, an HDMI, and a display port. It also has a spot for you to put your SD cards and an Ethernet port. It also has a spot for you to plug in your headphones. It basically turns my iPad into a proper workstation and really bridges the gap between a mobile setup and my desktop workflow. So that's what my setup looks like when I'm at the office. It's super minimal and it's just enough for me to stay focused on the things that I need. But the issue is I'm not always at my desk. And a big part of using the iPad is being able to take it anywhere. It's portable. So let me show you what my setup looks like when I'm on the go. Now, of course, when I leave the office, I can't carry around that big external monitor that I use. And the issue is once you use a second screen, it's really hard to go to just one, especially if it's just the iPad.
And that is why I carry a portable monitor with me. In my case, the Dopesplay 15.6 monitor. It's lightweight and super slim. It has a full 1080p display and it's clear, bright, and perfect for me to use as a secondary screen to my iPad. It has a headphone jack, 2 USB-C ports, and a mini HDMI port, making it flexible enough for me to connect multiple devices to it, kind of like what I'm doing right now. I also like the fact that it has its own kickstand built into it, so I can prop it up anywhere and have the perfect viewing angle no matter where I'm seated. Portable also means that I can't rely on a traditional wall outlet to power my devices. So when I'm out and about, what do I use to charge everything? And that is where this Anker Prime Power Bank comes into play. It has a maximum capacity of 27,650 milliamps. It has two USB-C ports and a USB-A port with a maximum output of 100 watts. So I can power the iPad, I can power the portable monitor, and still have enough juice left over to charge my other devices. This is an absolute powerhouse, keeping me running for hours, and it allows me to maintain the same workflow that I have at the office, just smaller and more mobile. Actually, hold on just one second. So good.
With just these two additions, the portable monitor and the power bank, the rest of my setup falls into place. My iPad in the ESR case, the Sony XM5s, and the MX Anywhere 3S all come together seamlessly, allowing me to efficiently work anywhere I go. But here's the thing, as good as this setup is, it's not perfect. It's clear that the iPad is far more capable than it was a few years ago, but it isn't until you start using it every day and relying on it that you notice that there's still a little bit of room for improvements. Multitasking, for example, gestures are a lot better than what they used to be, but it isn't until you start moving stuff around between your iPad and your external monitor and you just realize that everything is a little clunky. I don't know if that's the right word here, but that's how it feels. The external displays also don't behave like a traditional external monitor. Some apps don't scale properly and other features are limited by the built-in display. The battery life is generally solid, but when you're connecting so many different peripherals to the iPad, it can drain a lot faster than you would assume. Now, honestly, these aren't true deal breakers, but you will start noticing these little things when your iPad becomes your main device. And I think being upfront with these limitations helps us set realistic expectations so we have an idea of where the iPad still has room to grow. What once sat tucked away in a drawer collecting dust can now handle almost everything I need to do at my desk, and I can take it everywhere. Between the iPad OS 26, the windowing apps, and the right accessories, it's gone from a tablet that can handle some light work to now a powerful workstation that I can take with me everywhere I go. So here's my question to you. Are you ready to completely switch over to the iPad, or do you think the laptop is still here to stay? Drop a comment down below to let me know what your setup looks like, or if you need some recommendations because you're finally ready to build out your iPad setup. As always, thank you so much for hanging out with me. I truly appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next video.